place where dreams are made and skulls are broken. No matter whether it's astral granite, warp stone infused rock, or good old-fashioned dirt and grass, all Blood Bowl pitches share some key features.
You're absolutely right, Bob. I can smell the freshly cut grass way up here in the box.
Ah, what a wonderful smell, Jim. Perhaps we should catch up with Alyssa for a closer look from down there.
Thanks, Jim. Bob. Games of Blood Bowl are played on a rectangular field called the pitch, measuring a regulation 26 squares long and 15 wide. The pitch is marked with several distinct zones. The two end zones cover the short sides. That's where you need to get the ball to score a touchdown. There are also two wide zones which run the length of the pitch. The middle area between the two wide zones is called the center field. The pitch is split in the middle by the line of scrimmage, where the teams face off and most of the violence unfolds. The sidelines are marked at the edges of the pitch. Each team has a dugout on one side of the pitch, where the coaches, support staff, and any reserve teammates wait for their chance to get in on the action. The dugout is also where players will go when they're injured. Not if, but when. The dugout is marked with numbered strips to help you keep track of which turn it is, how many team re-rolls you have remaining, and of course, the all-important score. You'll also use several templates to keep your games of Blood Bowl running smoothly. The range ruler is used primarily for throwing the ball. It measures both the length and difficulty of the action, and also which opposing players might be able to attempt an interception. When a ball misses the intended target or gets dropped, you'll need the random direction template to help you determine which direction it bounces. Finally, the throw-in template is used to return the ball when it leaves the pitch for any reason. You may have noticed numbers on the templates. These are used in conjunction with a special set of Blood Bowl dice. As we mentioned in the last video, dice are used in Blood Bowl to determine the outcome of events, such as where a ball bounces, or if a player can successfully smash through the armor of his opponent with a bone-crunching block. These are the dice you'll use. Two six-sided dice. Individually, we call these dice D6. Most rolls in Blood Bowl are made using a D6. Sometimes, you might need to roll both dice together and combine the result. This is referred to as 2D6. In other instances, you might be asked to roll a D3 to resolve a particular outcome. Do this by rolling a D6 and halving the result, rounding up. So, a 1 or 2 gives you a score of 1. A 3 or 4 gives you a score of 2, and a 5 or 6 gives you a score of 3. 1 8-sided dice. This octahedron is used for working out which direction a dropped ball bounces. 1 16-sided dice. This is usually rolled to help you select a random player from your team. A Blood Bowl team never has more than 16 players on its permanent roster. And a set of 3 block dice with markings to determine the outcome of your clashes. We'll explain what these do when it's time to start fighting.
Very down-to-earth reporting for an elf.
Let it go, Bob. Thank you, Alyssa. Now that we have some solid ground beneath our feet, we can tackle the pre-game sequence.